Hi, welcome to my free Java video course, lesson 2. My name is Markus Biel. I'm a software craftsman with 14 years of experience in Java. My goal is to teach you Java in the easiest possible way. You can actually help me by sending feedback to my email address. I need your feedback for two reasons. First, based on your personal feedback, I'm going to continuously improve the training. Second, your feedback will motivate me to continue and record further lessons. I will answer every email. Thank you. In session 2 of this free Java video course, we are going to write our first Java program. When we write code, we actually start by writing a program which is actually testing the program or class we are going to write. We do this for two reasons. First, the test forces us to properly think our idea through, which will improve our code a lot. Second, the main effort in the life cycle of a program is actually not the first time effort of writing the program code, but to maintain the program, like extending or improving the functionality or fixing errors, called bugs, in your code. Whenever you write code, there is a high risk you will introduce defects in your code. When your program is written once with the help of a test, this test will ensure that whatever happens, your program will continue to function as designed initially. To recap, in lesson 1 of this free Java video course, I explained the necessary theory to code our first Java program, which we are going to do in a minute. We are going to use these 15 Java keywords and concepts described in detail in the prior session. If you haven't done yet, I would recommend you to start with session 1 before watching this practice session. Okay, so now I'm in my development environment. I've created a folder structure of com Markus Biel Java course lesson 2 in a folder called test, and also here source main Java com Markus Biel Java course lesson 2. This is where we will write our test. I've already created the file person-test.java. This here is where later we will have our actual program. But okay, so let's start. Person test. As described in lesson 1, we have to start with a package declaration. So I write, and you see here, I actually get support by my environment. About the development environment, I'll tell you later. For now, just see that it actually assists you. Actually, when you start learning to program, I would recommend you to start with a regular text editor, because you need to learn all these keywords, and so I guess it's easier in the beginning. I mean, not easier, but it helps you to learn the stuff from scratch if you really have to focus and concentrate and you don't get assistance. But as soon as you managed all these keywords, as soon as you know all them, such an environment is really helpful. Okay, so I use package, and then now I have to define it. Com Markus Biel, see how it assists me again. It already knows the package because I have here the folder structure, and the folder structure and the package declaration in my file actually have to be the same, otherwise this would be an error. So actually I don't even have to write it anymore. I can just follow. Okay, so this is my package. And you see before we had an underline, a red underline, which meant something is wrong. Now our editor seems to be fine with what I wrote so far. Okay, here we later will have imports as described in lesson 1, but we will add them later. Normally you start defining your class first. See again, I wrote public, and see how it's underlined red. So something is missing. So I say class, and now I have to define the class name. I say person test. So I call my test person test. It's a test for our first program, which is the class person. Okay, and now I have to add the brackets. When I add the first one, my editor already adds the second one, because for every opening bracket, you always need a closing bracket. Okay, so this is the beginning, and this is the end of my person test. Okay, now I add the annotation test, so that I define I want to write a test. And see, magically, the import appeared, because my environment already knows I want to write a test. The test also, is actually a class, and it even has a package, and this is org.junit test. We'll talk much more about JUnit in later lessons, but for now, we just know this is a test magically somehow. Okay, and we need a test method. The test method will be public. It won't return any value, so it will be void. And I will give it the name what I want it to do. Should return hello world. Hello world is actually like a running gag of programmers. Someone, I don't know who, once started that the first program you write in a language should return hello world. So we do that too. And I write a test for my first hello world program. I expect my person to return hello world to me, and I'm going to test this. We haven't written any actual code for person, but we're starting reverse. So we're starting with a test, as explained before. So now I can just assume I was done. You see it's red, which means we don't have a class person yet, but this doesn't matter. Now for this person, I need a variable name. And as my name is Marcus, just for fun, I call it person. I call the person Marcus. Okay, now I have to create the person Marcus. Remember, this was calling the constructor, creating the object, and this is creating the object of person from the type from the class person, and the equal sign assigns that object, which is created in the memory of our PC, to the variable, to the reference variable person, because this is a reference that we can later on use referencing the person. Okay, now this is red, but we'll take care of this later. We just continue. Okay, so assuming we were done, what do we want? We want to test something. And testing, we say we want to assert something. We want to assert that a method we're going to write is returning the hello world for us. So we want to compare if our expectation is equal to what the method is going to return. So we say assert equals. This also is starting as red, because we will have to import more stuff. But for now, we just take it. I use, this was again magic. I add one quotation mark, and my environment already adds the closing quotation marks. This is what we call a string. And I say hello world, because I want my person to return hello world for me. So the first part here is the expected return value. Now I add a comma, and now I have to add what is going to be tested. Marcus dot for calling a method, hello world. So on the object Markus of class person, I want to call a method hello world with no parameters given. And what is returned here, I want to assert that it equals to hello world. Now, this is not going to work because we still have some red stuff. For example, here we don't have actually written the class. But here we will let our environment help us. You see, now I just have to say create class person. Sorry, again. Create class person. And here it already asks us destination package, create class person, com Markus Biel, Java course, lesson 2. Okay, sounds good. Because our test and the actual class of the test will be in the same package. This actually helps us a lot, but more about this later on. I say okay, and magically our first class got created. You see here the package and the class. This is actually kind of the smallest class possible, just with opening and closing bracket, but it doesn't do anything yet. Okay, but you see, it's not red anymore. So let's go to the next, assert equals. It wants to import something statically. As said before, I will later on tell you what means static import, but for now, just believe me, we have to import this. This is another import from org.junit, but this time it's an assert. And so this is like a method. We import the method assert equals. But don't focus too much on this. We'll go in more detail later. For now, what is important? We want to write our first test. So here we still need to define a method. And it also tells us cannot resolve method hello world. Okay, help us please. Create method hello world. Ah, weird enough. It moved the method to the wrong place, but I'll fix that. Of course, we need to have it here. Okay, now nothing red anymore, and we can start calling our first test. I say run, and this actually executed our first test, which again executed our first class that was automatically written. And here we see we have an error. It tells us a missing return statement. So I said we want to return a string. Here you see string, but as you see, the method is empty. We don't return anything. So let's fix that. Return. This is how we say it. We have to say return. And now I just have to type hello world. Exactly as I was expecting it. I add the colon to say yes, do it. Return hello world. Okay. Now I switch over to the test. And I'll execute the test again. And it's green. All tests passed. This is our first test, and it worked, running our first class. Ta-da! Okay, thank you. That's it. Okay, that's it for now. Don't forget to send me your feedback. I'm highly interested if you were able to follow my explanations. Please give me feedback what you did or did not understand, where was too fast or too slow. I will answer every email and will try my best to incorporate your feedback in the sessions. Actually, I might even re-record a session based on your feedback. Thanks for watching and hope to hear from you soon.